Hello everyone, and welcome once again to a brand new, as of upload, DLC to GTA Online, where in this video I'm going to be going over the general gist of the brand new heist that was introduced into GTA Online, what my experience was when playing through all the heist setups and the finale, some tips and tricks, and overall just give my own thoughts and opinions about the heist. And to begin, I'm going to sum up this entire content update in just two words. My God, what an absolute
naughty word
this whole thing has been. Right, where do we begin? Well, before we get ahead of ourselves, let's start from the beginning. You spawn into GTA Online just outside the casino. Inside is a new place where some DJ is playing questionably good music. It's very similar to the nightclubs that you can own. Anyways, if you make your way to this area, you'll be introduced to the main guy who tells you everything that you need to know. Unfortunately, I could only make out half of what he was saying because I can't hear you! What? Can you speak up a bit? Seriously, did no one at Rockstar playtest this and think, there's gonna be a cutscene here where the characters are gonna reveal important information? It'll be fine. Let's just make it so that the two characters are talking to each other in the midst of all this nice loud music. Cause that's what you wanna have to rely on, eh? Subtitles. No, I'm sorry, but I can watch every other cutscene in the game just fine. You can tell me in the comments all you like that my sound settings are wrong and that you could hear them just fine, but I didn't happen to know this before going into the cutscene, so it's the game's fault, not mine. What's even funnier is that your own character's face pretty much matches exactly how you would be if you were in person in this situation. It's like, just shut up! Anyways, he basically tells you that you need to buy a submarine to start things off, so $9 million down the drain, and here we are. This has got to be the best character in GTA 5, bar none. I love this guy so much. He's like Lester, but more cheeky breeky. I almost expect him to say, mind-blowing orgies. Anyways, he shows you around the place, he tells you how to start doing preparation work, and you are on your way. The first thing you do is visit the island. You're in disguise, you take the first glimpse at the island as you drive to a party that's being held, you enjoy said party that's put on for a little bit, and then you go all around the island evading guards and surveillance cameras as you gather intel. My God, the lag! Oh my God, it's so laggy, what the hell? 20 FPS at best on my high-end rig at 1080p resolution. It's so laggy, oh, look at this. Right now, what you're seeing is with the graphics set to minimum except for grass quality. Later on, I turned that down to minimum as well and even turned the game down to 720p. And even then, it's incomprehensibly laggy and it's just not enjoyable to look at the screen. I can't imagine what this is like for consoles. Anyways, a quick workaround to prevent yourself from vomiting from this slideshow is to just look at either the floor or the sky at all times. This island is so unoptimized, and I get that I'm recording and that can relieve me of some of my frame rates, but there's been times where I haven't been recording and it's still an unplayable mess. Again, did Rockstar not test this? Anyways, besides the lag, this first mission was absolutely miserable. You're not allowed to use any weapons or equipment, and you're not allowed to be spotted at any time by either a guard or a security camera. Otherwise, a forced cutscene will play where guards take you back to the beginning. You have to pass this checkpoint to get pretty much anywhere on the island, and I thought to myself, right, well, there's a camera there, so there's no getting through here, so... Oh, I know, maybe if I go around the outside and swim around the island a bit until I can get back to dry ground using a beach or something to get in a better position, right? Well, good luck to you, sir, because once you get into the sea, besides a few secluded beaches, it's completely impossible to get back onto the island. I spent a good 15 minutes just swimming around the island trying in vain to find somewhere to get back onto the island. Eventually, I just gave up and blew myself up using one of the sea mines. Just kidding, I just drowned myself. Okay, so eventually I found that you can get through this checkpoint. It's just the minimap doesn't really accurately portray what the camera can and can't see. So just walk right through here, cross the island at 15 frames per second, do a bunch of stuff, and then optionally look around the island for anything to steal for the heist. It's all very self-explanatory. It's easy enough once you get past that first checkpoint. Once you're done, you fly back to Los Santos, you go to your submarine again, and then you start actually doing the prep missions. The prep missions are structured exactly the same as the ones in the casino heist. You do them in any order that you want, and you can do them all in free mode. They're all pretty easy, but I'd recommend you make sure that you have an automatic shotgun, as a lot of shootouts in the prep missions take place at close range. It's definitely more effective to use a shotgun than a carbine, in my opinion. There's a few juggernauts that you might run into at some point, but I found that if you just set them on fire in any way, like an incendiary round from a sniper rifle, or a Molotov, you can make them fall to the ground, writhing in pain, giving you the perfect opportunity to get up close safely and give them a dosage of vitamin D. One particular mission I have to point out is the one where you have to follow, which is quite possibly the slowest thing in existence, this Valkyrie. My God, you could probably feasibly follow this thing on foot while doing the moonwalk. This thing is so bloody slow. Traveling back and forth to the submarine during the prep missions can be a bit of a pain, so obviously you're going to want to use the Oppressor Mark II for quick and easy travel. Just make sure to immediately call the thing back using the Motorcycle Club menu before it slides into the ocean whenever you land on the submarine. The top of the submarine is pretty slippery, as it counts as an actual vehicle, which I'll get to in another video, and it's 10,000 down the drain if it goes into the water. Anyways, once you've got all the prep work done, which involves all the mandatory as well as some optional side missions, like the ones which let you choose different weapons, you can pretty much start the heist mission. But there's also the option of having some NPC support during the mission in the form of the airstrike, the supply drop, the sniper, the helicopter backup, the recon drone, and the weapon stash. To be honest, the first time I played the mission, besides the helicopter backup and the recon drone, I had absolutely no idea how to use any of them. I bought them all for the mission just to see what they could do. I activated them all as soon as I could take out the control tower, which is a requirement to be able to use anything. The recon drone was great. It revealed all the enemy's locations near me, allowing me to effectively combat them. The helicopter backup worked questionably well. And all the rest, I was in the dark. The sniper was constantly going on at me, telling me that I need to mark some targets. Hell if I know how to do that, Sonny Jim. And the airstrike requires that you throw a flare to set a target. Well, if I'm in range to throw a flare at whatever I want to destroy, then I may as well just use my gun to shoot them. All of the rest, I didn't really get the chance to figure out how to use them. Or if there was a hint text box that showed up, I didn't see it. Anyways, the final heist. My God. Anyways, with all the settings at lower than your mama could ever go, I began the mission stealthily. I chose the loadout that gives me the sniper rifle, the AP pistol, and Molotov cocktails, as well as buying the optional suppressor package. I took out a surveillance camera, took out the two guards that were guarding the control tower, and... Really? Really?! Oh my God. Okay. Okay. Oh, fine, yep. The guards magically know exactly where I am at all times, rendering the whole stealth aspect completely obsolete. Helicopters start spawning in infinitely, and what was supposed to be a fun stealth mission turned into a mission that I spent most of the time just running from cover to cover, tanking all the shots using snacks and body armor. Fun. My God, all the fun that could have been had just went out of the window. It immediately obsoleted the sniper rifle, except for the odd time where I shoot at a pilot just because I get really mad and want them dead. I just had to run like hell everywhere that I went, crossing the island while being chased by helicopters and guards constantly peppering me with rifles, frantically pressing the action button to get the stupid door to open to get into the compound, get all the loot, and it's basically a friggin' action movie as an unlimited number of guards and helicopters closing on my position, one of them being a Valkyrie. Then with my butt clenched and my interaction menu open to replace all the armor that I lose from taking the hail of bullets, I make my way to the world's slowest aeroplane. Come on! Come on! Then... Heist complete. jeez, that was not fun. Not fun at all. But that was my experience. I mean, it wasn't all bad. Because of the loadout that I chose, I had access to Molotovs, which allowed me to very easily take out the Juggernauts which chased me down, and it would have been pretty difficult to take them out if I didn't have them. So from my experience of completing the heist, is there any advice that I can give you? Well, you can turn down your graphic settings for one if you're on PC, and for the actual heist, I'd recommend equipping a more powerful loadout than I had. Yes, there are Juggernauts, but I only really ran into one, so especially if you have more than one guy on the heist helping you out, I did all of this solo by the way, you can probably make better use of a more hands-on loadout. To save a lot of time and to make things more efficient, I'd recommend just nicking a vehicle, opening up the interaction menu, and just tanking all the shots that you will inevitably take while you travel across the island. It's what I ended up doing when I was exfiltrating the island, and that worked out well. It wasn't fun, but it worked. Overall, I'd say this is by far the worst heist in GTA Online. The performance of the game being on the island alone is enough to turn me off doing repeat heists. But even then, just how it's structured and how it inevitably falls down to just tanking shots rather than using strategy, it takes away a lot of the fun in completing the heist in my opinion, especially with how much time it took to actually do all the prep missions. Over time, people are going to inevitably come up with much more effective strategies and tricks to get the most money out of doing this heist, as well as making the heist as efficient as possible. But those guides will most likely not come from me. I'm not really a fan of doing the heist personally. As I say, it's just not fun to do this heist in my opinion. But hey, what do you think? Let me know in the comments and stay tuned for more Cayo Perico, I can't name it, heist DLC guides coming to you very soon. See you around, folks.